everywhere. Ain't no need for us to hide. Got a question, he's the answer. This is the church in the wild. Uh-huh. We here. We here. We here. We here.
And we are go.
What up, Corey Ball? With no respect. Been playing with Philly since 2012. This is my first one.
Your first?
I just flew in from Los Angeles about. I got here like 10 minutes before I got on stage.
It's real. Like, yeah. I'm playing. I'm in the building. I'm on the stage.
Yeah, it was cool, man. It was cool. It was a blessing, man. It was crazy. Honestly, there's really so little Christian industry in Los Angeles. All the Christian industry is this side of the Mississippi. So I don't get to hear and hang out with a lot of other producers.
Okay.
So I don't really get to test, you know, my tracks up against that. So it was cool to see that people see it well. Because I don't do the down south stuff. Right, I don't do none of that stuff. So I don't really trap. Okay. So it was cool to see them put me through, you know what I mean?
So you've been producing for...
Let's see, I'm V Rose's producer.
You know what I mean? For how long? I know.
The credits. Okay,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, you got a game.
Man, I've been producing for about 10 years.
10 years of producing. When it's time to go on the stage for the battle, are you even nervous? Or if it's like.
You know what, man? There's a healthy amount of nervousness.
Okay, just to,
that go with everything, but it's more anticipation. It's like, man, it's like the opportunity to share your gifts.
Right.
Every third person on earth wants to share their gifts and their talent. So it's like to get an opportunity to do it.
Yeah.
It's exciting. Yeah, it's exciting. So
you know,
they passed me through unanimous. All three judges like, spank it the nod. I was like, thank you guys. So it was cool. It was cool.
Man.
Yeah, I was excited about
it. Okay, this is what we're doing today on Church of the Wild.
Church of the Wild.
This season two.
All right.
We already did season one,
okay.
So we're opening up in favor. And we want to open up all. So the question is, do I believe that guilt is one of the main things that holds a person back?
Man, that is phenomenal. Do you want my 30-second answer or do you want my 2-minute answer?
What's your 2-minute answer?
All right, 2-minute answer.
Two minutes.
Okay. The question was, do you believe guilt is one of the main things that holds a person back? I believe that guilt is the only thing that holds a person back.
It's the part, okay.
I believe that guilt is the only thing. When God made man, he made us perfect, right?
Okay.
Right? And we were naked. But we were not ashamed. And the relationship was whole.
Right.
When we sinned, the first thing, when God came into the presence, the first thing Adam did was they covered up. It was guilty. And what it symbolized is a separation, right? In the New Testament, it was the same thing with the veil.
Yeah.
The veil was just like clothes. It was guilt. It was not being able to come into his presence.
Right.
So salvation is actually just a reconciliation between man and God. It's taking the guilt away. That's all it is. So when Jesus came to cover sins, he was just taking away the thing that caused guilt. So I believe guilt is the only thing that holds something back. And it happens in everything. You know, talents, treasures, man, no matter what it is, it's like you believing that you can't do it or you're not good enough is the only thing that will hold somebody back.
Condemnation
that those that are in Christ Jesus. But people do not believe that, right? And so when a person gets saved, the traditional church tells them to focus on not sinning anymore. And that is not the thing to concentrate on. When you get saved, your sins are covered. Your sins are negligible.
Right.
You don't even have to worry about them anymore.
Right.
So the guilt is what stops you. Stop worrying about not sinning. Yeah. Worry about getting closer to God. See, in God's presence, sin can't even exist in His presence. As you go closer to Him, it'll just start falling off, melting off. You can't do it. So focus on getting closer to God. So that's why. Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Guilt will keep you away from God, whether it's the world telling you you're guilty or whether it's the church telling you you're guilty. Focus on not sinning. Focus on not sinning. And every day, you just sin conscious. Sin conscious. Focus on not sinning. Through what he set up. like? Bless this person, bless that person, give me this, bless them, give me this, help me. What does worship sound like? I give to you, I love you, I worship you. What do you have me to do? I lay myself down at your feet. It's the conversation. If you came up to your dad every day and all you did was ask him for stuff, that would be a certain type of relationship. If you went to your dad and said, Dad, what are we doing today?
Yeah.
What are you doing today? Can I roll with you today,
Whatever you do, I want to do.
Could I go to work with you?
Yeah.
Can you show me how to do the family business?
Yeah.
It's different than just asking it.
How close
it's is it? How close. You can't even know what God wants you to do. You have no direction or purpose in life.
Right.
You are walking around dealing with sin unless you are following God's purpose.
So, okay, I love it. I absolutely love it.
Perish because of the lack of knowledge, they do, but the Bible also says that the Holy Spirit will teach you all things.
So all I need.
All you need is to be connected. That's it. Seek God. Seek God.